Hey everybody, it's Quentin back at the Canine Homestead.
And Haley.
And we've got some odd jobs for you first. We kind of finished up the pool area last night, spread our pine needles, and then we're getting into some projects.
So we picked up some river rocks.
And river rocks. So come follow along, let's get to work. Right where we're working.
I can bet we can figure it out in one guess.
It looks like it's Esme poop, but I'm guessing it was Paisley.
I'm thinking it was Paisley.
Paisley always has to tell me she owns the ground that I'm standing on. I've already transplanted probably 100 of these iris bulbs. See how many more we can get out of here. Get the grass out of it. A baby! A baby! Baby iris!
This is like where I excel because I'm great at killing
plants. You're not killing them, you're actually helping them. They do better.
Right, but I don't have to keep them alive if they're in this thing.
Nice swell. Stuff's gold right here.
Well, it has all the compost from our herb garden.
No, it's the original compost from Linda. Oh.
Oh, yeah.
This is all the stuff that was in those front flower beds I moved the last time.
Yeah, but remember we had all those herbs that we just...
Yeah, I know, but I'm just saying that they grew really well because this is Linda's compost. Yes, really, if you wanted to, we could just go out there to the barn and just fill in around the barn. There's already 100 of them out there. Spread them out and have a giant circle of irises out there. So 2,000 years,
there was human intervention.
We need to stop watching conspiracies.
It wasn't conspiracy.
Yeah, I know. I mean, like, stuff that makes us, like, think back into the past so much. So this is the part that you can make medicine from.
Yep. Fun fact, iris rhizomes are good for headache relief, teething, hangovers, catch 22.
It's basically snake oil, except it works. The cure all.
We were commenting on, we were watching a documentary last night, and it was in Ireland on a very old farm, and they were talking about the Iron Age people would plant the irises for medicinal uses around where they were living on the islands. Hazel, get out of here.
And then we also discovered ties that the Native Americans used it. The first people. Oh,
I just grabbed a new stocking now. This is out of the bin.
I was talking about my, we're on native land. I don't like breaking them. I feel like I'm hurting it.
Thank you for freeing us from my parents. I'm ready to move out.
I'm trying to separate like the ones with the leaves from the other. Not that it matters, but I make it easier.
And any of these that we don't actually plant, we get some more potting soil. Or even we can use this too and put them in all those 1-quart planting pots and then let them grow and sell them next week. We have the nursery license.
Every time I pick up one that doesn't have leaves on it, I'm like, wait, is this dog poop?
Hazel.
Like, this is just wild.
Oh.
Like, how many of these there are. That one was like a U shape.
There was a lot in the ground when I moved them originally. Remember, we still have about... This is only a small portion. This is probably only 5% of the iris bulbs on property. Because back there in the woods, or right in the front of the woods, there's about a 30-foot by 30-foot section that's nothing but rhizomes.
Oh, wow.
It's just covered in poison ivy at the moment, so.
Yeah, we want to avoid that. I'm convinced.
Small. Don't try to do big scoops. Yeah, old days, it doesn't matter how fast it goes. The thing is, it's dry. It's not.
Yeah, but it's nice soil. Am I coordinated enough to do this with you at the same time? Oh, wait. There's rosemary in there somewhere.
What did they do? They must have come this way. I did not know this went this way. You want to look up on your phone and see what we... You can figure out what the item is that we need to go buy. So our drain pipe that comes off of our gutters, and I thought it steered more in that direction. I had no idea it ran this way. And of course, when I started swinging a pickaxe, it took me 2 hits before I realized, wait a minute, that's not right. So we've got a really good puncture here, and then I believe there's one down here as well. So we're gonna end up, yeah, right here, there's one there and one there. So we're gonna end up having to cut out about a 1 foot section, and we're gonna put in a patch and then bury it again. This is the moment where we take the walk of shame. Well, y'all, good thing about living on a farm and stockpiling all your stuff around here is I had what I needed to fix this problem without going anywhere. Grandpa's saw coming in handy there. Oh, that's an old one. Well, the goal, now that I've cut this, is we're gonna be sandwiching this around the existing pipe, and we're gonna zip tie it down. We just need to make sure we get all of this debris out of the way as best we can.
You're gonna have to just zip tight and work your way down.
Yeah, no, just trying to make sure it fits. Cool. All right. Well, it fits. We've got it cleaned up. I'm gonna go get some zip ties. We're gonna wrap it, make sure it's nice and snug, and then backfill and pack it in, and then attempt to not hit it again with the pickaxe. Crisis averted. Everything we needed to fix our problem at hand was either at our house or at my dad's. Because my dad and my mom live right across the street, so it's fairly easy to go grab some stuff if we need it. Trees are all rustling in the wind. Oh. What are all the dads supposed to do? I ain't going nowhere. We're good. For the time being. Just so we know where it's at.
Gonna hit it again.
I feel like I need to put out a disclaimer that this is like first fall that I've helped you do, like anything else. That's some pure clay right there. clip you want over there and then go from there.
Watch out, I'm gonna toss it up the dirt your way. Well, it has been a long 3 days of work, but we finally have the landscaping done around the pool area, and we can change our focus to closing the pool down for the winter and making sure we stockpile all of our wood from the deck and making sure it's out of the weather, because here in a couple months, this is going to be being turned into a playhouse for our children. But that's a project for another day. All right, everybody. It has been an incredibly long 3 days. I'm exhausted. Haley is too. She's in there taking a nap right now. But I'm out here with Beau, walking around, getting some sessions in with him. And, well, I think this is just as good a time as any to put a wrap on this video. So, you guys have a very good evening. Take care of yourselves, and we'll see you back here next time at the Canine Homestead.